لله رب العالمين، صلى الله عليه وسلم على نبينا حبيبنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Dear respected brothers and sisters, you are welcome. And this lecture will be, which will be about practical da'wah, in which we consider it is the aim of all these lectures and all these efforts. We aim to reach at the end to practice all these knowledge, inshallah. We have a rich program. We have a rich program actually. For almost 2 months, we started with Islam versus modern society. And actually, because we need to save time, we have various topics which we are sure that they will enrich our knowledge and our, inshallah, effort to help our brothers to save them. When we want to practice da'wah, of course there is a target. And of course, our da'wah will be given to someone. Before we start da'wah, we have to expect everything to meet. We will meet in our da'wah fair people. Sometimes, when you talk to someone about Islam, or when you talk to a Muslim about teachings of Islam to help him to practice ibadah the right way, sometimes you find fair people. They don't hate you, they don't hate your religion, they don't have distorted image of your religion, your society, your nationality, and everything. He listens to you, he doesn't mind to listen and to discuss. This kind of people is the majority. Fanatic people. Those people whom you talk to them, but they have in their mind something. They like it. And they don't like anything else, even if it is the correct thing. Like, sometimes, you know, Hindu, they cannot listen to you. They are closed society. Sometimes Buddha, and sometimes other religions. Sectarian. Even sometimes people, and it does happen for all religions, either Muslims or non-Muslims, Christian, Buddhism, Hinduism, and they belong to a sect, and they don't listen or hear or accept anything that has different idea of their belief. And sometimes you are lucky to have people like you can see a stick to know about your religion. Sometimes we had this so many times. You meet someone and he said, a long time I'm searching for someone who can guide us, who answer my question. He wants to hear about. We have so many examples. We have some brothers who embrace Islam. They went through maybe three religions or three beliefs, and finally they find Islam is the best, and they are. We have Brother George Maxwell with us in the office, he is dying with us. He went to many religions, beliefs, and finally he finds Islam is the best, and alhamdulillah, he is dying with us now. You will meet also some deaf people. They hear, but they hear only what they like. Still, I remember a story once الخميس مشيت near the Grand Mosque there. الشيخ أحمد الطواشي was reciting from Al-Baqarah chapter. American guy there, he stopped. You know, الشيخ أحمد الطواشي takes a long time in Al-Baqarah. He stopped and he doesn't know Arabic until he finished. There was a bookshop there belongs to our brothers in Khamis community center. He went to them and asked him. So this man is not deaf. He heard the reciting of the Holy Quran and it went to his heart, to his mind, and he started to discuss. He heard first, then he listened. He started to listen by his heart and his mind. Kind of people you have. Blind. SubhanAllah. Not eyes are blind. Heart is the blind. Some people, they see. They see only bad things. And they see only the thing that they think is the best in the life. The holy copy of the Holy Quran may be on his desk for a long time. He came to Saudi Arabia to or to any Muslim country. Or he has a good friend. He tells him about Islam. And of course, when we call someone to Islam, we don't have the right to force him. Neither prophets or prophets, peace be upon them, nor us. Just it is our duty to convey the message. If someone accepts the message, it belongs to him, and it is on life. And if not, so that on the day of judgment, we will be free in front of him. Allah will ask us about those who don't know anything about Islam. SubhanAllah, sometimes, you know, through media, books, brochure, pamphlets, and SubhanAllah, he knows it is about Islam, but due to his distorted background about Muslim society, about Islam, he doesn't see peace. Carelessness. Some people, it doesn't matter. Hear to you, but it doesn't matter to hear, to benefit, not. And he listens to you. When you finish, he leaves. He is, doesn't care about anything, even about his society, about himself. Spiteful. All these kinds will be among any society to deal with them. So be ready to all this. We will not spend a lot of time because still we have many things we want to go through them, and they are all very important for us. All these courses and all these lectures, at the end, if it doesn't, if these all lectures, these all efforts don't come to be practiced, so it will be all in vain. Of course, it is those people who only believe in logic, and there is so many ways to enlighten them, and they really all the world actually in need. It is religious people, ignorance, and this kind is very difficult. We have experience with it. Arrogance, people who despise others and see they are the top of the world, top of people. Some example, we have so many examples actually. We have an ancient example of the beginning of the age of Islam, the beginnings of Dawah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abdullah ibn Umm Maktum. Did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam preach Islam to him? No. But he himself, and please look at this word, he came. As I said before, there are some people who are eager to hear about Islam. So So he came to Prophet Muhammad, he was so busy with leaders of Quraysh to convince them about Islam, and you know the story in the Al-Quran. The other also example is Pharaoh. Allah sent Moses to him and his brother to Pharaoh. Abdullah ibn Maktoum, you remember, he came to the Prophet Muhammad. What about Pharaoh? Allah told Moses to what? To go. So there are some people who have to go to them. What did he say, Pharaoh? Did he say, I don't like your religion? I don't like any religion? I am the best person? No. He said, what? I am your Lord. Most High. So he wants to be a person of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What is beyond this? Also he said, for sheaves, I know not that you have an ilah God other than me. So he wants to be a partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A man like this arrogant, what do you think the best way to deal with him? The proper way to deal with him? To argue? Or to force him, or to curse him, or to bump him, or to slaughter him. This is what's happening now. So we don't actually follow our Islam and the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about. Yes. And speak to him what? What, brothers and sisters? Mind. Perhaps he may accept admonition of the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So who was then Pharaoh? And Allah told his prophet and messenger to speak to him, my friend. What Daesh and what Shia and what ignorant people around the world are doing, and they accuse Islam of terrorism. What is Islam? What to tell truth seekers first? It happened so many times. A brother who liked Dawah and practiced Dawah, he's in a situation that a person in front of him from different belief, and he wants him to tell him about Islam. What to tell him? About the Holy Quran, about pillars of Islam, about pillars of belief, about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about what? A huge question, but a simple answer. Also, as I told you about Pharaoh before, that speak to him mildly. Also the same here. The same will be here. We have paper, brother Amin. Can you kindly? Brothers, those who attended before a lecture like this, please, we will work in two or three groups. Here, we can be two groups. And one here. At the back, please, at the back of this paper. We need this paper for three times. The blank side, the blank face. Where from the blank face, please? Yes, yes. Where on the blank face? There are two faces, something is written here. Don't work it on it now. Work on the black 12 months. Validity section. What's the word? عليهم ويكتبون في الخلف. Please write on the back, back side of the paper. What is Islam? What I need now to in group, at least let us meet eyes. Ask your neighbor his name. We should know each other. Ask your neighbor his name and discuss together, please. What is Islam? To answer a person who is non-Muslim. And how to convey Islam to him. What to tell him? He wants to know Islam, what to tell him about Islam. Please write briefly on this paper. You have 3 minutes. 3 minutes, brothers and sisters. We have a lot of work, so please run it fast. You want to tell someone about Islam? What to tell him? Tell him about Quran, about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, teaching of Islam. This is the first step you do when you meet someone who wants to know about Islam. It happens to me, to you, you meet, you need a pen. You need pens? Sisters, do you need pens we have? Sister Fatma? Yes, I do not plan. One minute, finish. With a group, please. We have a question now.
Death is not exactly death. There's no end. It's kind of a transition. There is a transition after it's permanent. It's not permanent at all. That's what you have to explain. We have come up with 2 ideas.
Enough.
Right. Should I tell you? Yes. Tell me.
Right.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
So, Islam is the perfect way of life based on the belief that there is no God but Allah. Allah is the only one worth worshipping, no one else. And you came up with, I just can't read you.
then Mary could explain that there is messengers from Allah, and we can name them, Muhammad, Jesus, Moses, Noah, and Abraham.
The last point, we will explain for them the mercy of Islam, the beauty of Islam, some good points is kindness,
example, stories.
Yeah, stories from Islam.
We will deal the person according to his background. First, we will try to understand what nature he is educated or less educated. He is orthodox to his previous religion. First, we will
study. So, accordingly, go back to our classification.
Yes. And accordingly, we will meet. First of all, we will give a brief introduction of Islam. Not in aggressive, very simple, very cool, calm, and mindly. We will give a brief introduction.
Good.
Then, we will tell that Islam is not a mere religion.
Yes.
Like other religion. We will tell them Islam is not a mere religion but a way of life. It is a deen.
System of life.
Yes. And then we will define the meaning of Islam. Many religions in the world, it is derived from some personality or something. Islam is not from any person. Islam means submission to the will of the Lord. And obedient to only one God, and there is an ideal a Muslim to follow, that is the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And we will try to convince him Islam is a natural religion, it is a nature. Things around us, all are Muslim. The sky, the earth, the trees and birds and animals, they are all Muslim. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given a liberty to human being that you can choose. Inna hadayna najdain. Both options are open for you. You think over it.
Science.
And accept this one. No force in Islam. La ikraha fid din.
No compulsion.
No compulsion. If you are convinced, you really believe that this is the nature, that in the nature of the human being, there is something to accept the truth. So if he comes, we can go proceed to
it. Yeah. Thank you. Second line, please. We need one answer.
Auzubillahiminashaitanirrajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. If someone is asking about the his Islam, so you must tell them to it's a true religion and a good religion. And we must tell the definition of the Islam. We will read the Surah Kul. Kul Allahu Allahu Samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. We explain his language.
It's the oneness of Allah.
Yeah, it's a definition of Allah.
You are looking for a simple answer. So what is Islam? This would be like full submission to Allah. And for the group seekers, I would suggest to study the Quran, analyze it, to believe in it.
Exactly.
Assalamu alaikum. First of all, we will tell him about the beauty of Islam and its submission to the will of God.
Yes.
By full obedience and no compulsion in our religion. And tell him to not focus in the media or take his information from the media, because the media is distorting the image of Islam.
Yes.
So when he took it from the scholars, from the right persons, right
source.
People,
right.
The right source, from the Holy Quran, yeah. From the traditional Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, he will find the truth of Islam and the beauty of Islam.
Thank you. Last group. Yes, can you help us, please? The mic.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. We should make Ramadan by many important factors, but first we should show for the Muslims our morals, our Islamic morals. They don't know the Muslims in a general way. They only know that we are terrorists, so we must show for them the fact of Islam, the beauty of it. Thank you.
Our sisters, two answers, please. You have mine or not?
No.
But you can get it from me, please. Switch it off. Yes, sister?
Assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum salam.
To make dawah to non-Muslims, most especially to those people who are stick to their religion, like Protestant, Buddhist, and Hindus, and other religion, first, we approach them in a nice way and explain from the Quran about Islam.
Yes.
First, we tell them the meaning of Islam. Islam is a sign of peace.
Yes.
And number two, Islam is the way of truth, the way to paradise. And number three is that Islam is full submission to the will of Allah.
Yes.
And other is Islam is the final religion revealed to our Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, by Angel Gabriel. We explain this gradually. Because if we force them to understand, most especially the fanatic people, they don't accept.
Thank you.
Time.
Another answer? There is? Or finished? But thank you. Jazakumullah khair, very nice answers. Let us say the hadith, Sahih hadith. When Jibreel came to Prophet Muhammad in a manner of a man, extraordinary black hair and white clothes, no fatigue of traveling, of journey of traveling, and he said to Prophet Muhammad, tell me about Islam. This is my question today. This question was asked by whom? By Jibreel. And the answer will be from? We know this hadith, so we know he is Jibreel who asked this. But others, no, they didn't. The Sahaba companions of Prophet Muhammad that day, they don't know. At the end of the hadith, they asked him, who is he? So what he said? Islam is to what? Testify that one has the right to worship, the one who has the right to worship but Allah. No one has the right to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To be witness that there is only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger. See, inshallah, when we say them all, what we will conclude with. And then, you observe salah, you perform salah. This is number two. Then pay zakah. Give zakah, charity, which is in Islam, taken from rich people to poor people, not to the government. It is not a tax. Zakah, observe some, fasting Ramadan. Now, fasting Ramadan number four. That means Ramadan from early morning to sunset, half day fasting, and before Hajj. This is number five. So to be noticed that there is only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Muhammad is the last messenger, his messenger and the last messenger. Second, to perform salat. Third, to fast Ramadan. Fourth, to give zakat, charity. Five, to perform hajj. And perform hajj if you are able financially and physically. There are two conditions. What are these five things?
Pillars
of
Islam.
Don't bother yourself. When you are in the presence of someone, he asks you about Islam, or you want to tell him about Islam, don't bother yourself. Morality, Holy Quran, beauty of Islam, all these things will come, yes. But he wants to know what is his religion. To be a Muslim, what shall I do? So, five things. We want one from here to give them for us, please, quickly. Who can volunteer? The five pillars of Islam. Someone, a volunteer from here. A volunteer?
Yes.
Only one volunteer? Yes. Your name, please.
My name is Salih.
Excuse
me, I have just a question. But this question was applied to somebody who is real Muslim. But your question is a question for non-Muslim. If some non-Muslim ask you about Islam,
yes.
You will not, I think it's not the right way to tell him about the pillars of Islam. He needs to know the beauty of Islam.
Thank you. Just kindly give us the five pillars, remind us only.
To pray, what is that? There is only one God.
Yes.
Okay, prayer.
Yes.
Zakat, charity, psalm, fasting, the month of Ramadan, performing Hajj.
Thank you, Brother Salih. The answer will be coming, inshallah, on the next slide. Thank you. Our sisters, kindly want to repeat? Yes? No answer? Fine. Thank you. You know, Brother Saleh and my brothers and sisters here, Jibreel came to you to teach you your religion. There is another hadith. Thank you. Please go. Go ahead. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent to Ma'ad to Yemen. And he said, you will come. Ta'ti qawman ahl kitab. People of scripture. They are non-Muslims. The same way, Brother Saleh, he said, sorry, let's go to the English. One. You are going to some people from among the people of Bok. People of scripture, they are anonymous. And also the same story. Be witness that there is only one God. And Muhammad is the last messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes, of Allah. Five prayers, sadaqah or zakat, the same thing. You know, it is, yes, Islam is beautiful for us because we are Muslims. And we know it's beautiful. But people who know Islam through media, and their background is bad about Islam, and Islam distorted in their image. You cannot in one time say Islam. What shall you say about Islam? It's very beautiful, yes. But what will you tell him of the beauty of Islam? In one meeting, you cannot. So this is the first message, as Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, and as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before that told us through your prayer. And when Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent Ma'ad to Yemen to call them, remember Allah. Say Subhanallah. Say Allahumma salli ala Muhammad. Today is Friday. Are we in lack of da'iyah making da'wah? Where is the place of da'wah? What is the main purpose of da'wah? Shall we blame non-Muslims when they accuse us or accuse Islam? Whom to be blamed? All of us know the answers. These are the keywords will help you. Maybe question one is clear. The answer is what? Yes. Right. You have 1 minute, please. No need for explanation. The slide explain itself. Number two, where is the place of da'wah? Mine, box, or field?
Everywhere.
Field. What are the main pillars of da'wah? This will be another slide, so I will not answer it. Here, three things, remember them. And finally, whom to be blamed. Did we do our duty the right way? To convey the message, the beauty of Islam. Here in Saudi Arabia, we have over 10 million patriots. Did we do our duty the right way? Did we convey the message to them? Sometimes some people come and stay for maybe 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, and he leaves as he came with nothing, while they are living among us. There is a comparison said by a brother before that between consultant physician. Maybe we have some physicians here and knowledgeable da'iyah. If consultant physician is at home or at clinic making a lot of researches and he has a lot of knowledge about medicine, and his door is closed, and he is busy all time searching. What about patients and sick people? They will not believe it. What about diet? Knowledgeable diet. He has a lot of knowledge. He knows the strategy. He has health, and he has all things that be needed by someone to make da'wah, and he is in his office. Daytime, he is in his office. After work, he is at house with his family all time, or his friends. What is the benefit? Why patients around him? Remember, usually one word makes the difference. It must be a kind word. You have to choose the proper way, and you have to deal and talk to others, not only to Muslims, to others in a kind way. Also, one action makes the difference. There is a very important action which is missed actually in our day life, in our da'wah. What do you think of this action? Very easy. Huh? I'm making it now.
Please.
Act? What?
Smiling.
Thank you. What's your name? Adam Nasser Shehri. There is a gift for you. Inshallah, I will find what they are. Huh? I don't know. I am afraid. It will be. It may be 100. You said 100. You deserve. Adam Nasser. No, this is a gift. You have to take it. It's not a charity. Stand up. Thank you, Adonis. Thank you. Smile. He was the only one smiling in the place. Thank you, Adonis. Yes. It's very important. Smile. It opens the heart. You have a lot of knowledge. And you have self-confidence. And you see, you have in your mind, I will defeat anybody. I have a lot of knowledge. I know how to argue. I know how to debate. But this is not the proper way. This is the question. Turn the paper. You have the other side. And now we will shift to mathematics. we will shift to mathematics. On the other side of the paper, other face of the paper, you have emotion plus knowledge equals what? Is there anybody who is specialized in mathematics here? Ladies? Right. Emotion plus enthusiasm. People who are eager to make dialogue. And enthusiasm and knowledge equals what? Remember, this course is for that. It's not mathematics. Something missed. Don't tell me now. Write it in your paper with your neighbor. And here, emotion plus what? Equals what? Enthusiasm with what? Equals what? And knowledge plus what?
C.
There is successful dialogue. I don't know where successful dawah. I will help you to answer this question. Successful dawah will be where? Yes, go ahead. You have 1 or 2 minutes, no problem.
Life is simple. The notion of life is simple.
After a while, you will shift to science. After mathematics, you will shift to science.
Spaces and one word is missing. Here, right?
Yes.
Brainstorming.
Shall I help you? I will answer the first one. Emotion plus knowledge equals zero. Equals zero. You have knowledge and you have emotion. Alas, equals zero. There is no doubt. Alas, I answered the first one. Work together.
I want knowledge and
nothing.
Knowledge and faith.
Thank you.
Maybe I
one-handed. You need
knowledge and patience.
He wants 100 for that.
Knowledge and patience. Faith. Knowledge and faith.
1 minute finished.
Knowledge and faith.
1 minute left. Dear brothers and sisters, these things which makes the successful die.
Yes, brother?
Patience. Thank you for
the
answer. What else?
I said patience, first of all.
Yes,
Professor.
Expression. How you can make the data, how you can convince a person. That is what we mean.
Thank you. Please.
Knowledge plus.
Last same question. Yes, good.
Go ahead. One answer.
Anything else?
My second. I am talking about the successful data.
Yes.
It needs knowledge and the expression.
Thank you.
That means the successful data.
Thank you.
Once you can, you are
express,
in a position, you explain yourself and to express your feelings.
You are very close. You answered very close to the answer. Thank you. Let's make sure that there is no more one. Yes, if
this one, I haven't covered all the answers. Although it has a little
more. Wisdom also came before. Thank you. Let us go step by step. Emotion and knowledge equals what?
Nothing.
There is no doubt. Emotion and enthusiasm. Nothing also, in the same place. Enthusiasm and knowledge, the same, nothing. But now we will go to the difficult question. Emotion plus what equals what?
Sincerity.
You see? Thank you. It's very important. You see? What is missed now is what is really missed in our life, in our Dawah. And it is the key word in Dawah. It is a key word. You know, when a Muslim is killed here or there, sometimes you cry. But we do not. We want the Islam and the right morality to win or to control the world or to spread, but this is emotional. Some people read and make research and read, but in their offices, in drawers.
Work.
Huh?
Work.
Practice. Practice. Engineer after one. We deserve 100, but later on, inshallah, on the graduation ceremony, inshallah. Even practice, brothers. Wait, practice. Halas, put here practice. Put practice. And what is the answer? Emotion and practice. What benefit? Thank you, our sisters. No. Emotion and practice. You will go the wrong way. Enthusiasm and practice. You will go the wrong way like that, or share. Like what else now? Knowledge? Plus? Plus? Plus?
Practice.
Practice. Knowledge? Plus? Practice.
I think application.
Application.
More better. Knowledge, what knowledge you have,
thank
you have to apply.
Thank you, but
that's
there is
more
no,
important.
No 100. Thank you.
Right.
Application or practicing? Application or practicing?
Modern.
So, dear brothers and sisters, this missing word in this lecture is missed in our life, is missed in our dialogue. Thank you very much. Now, big problem now. Who can read this? Yes, brother? This slide.
Dawah obstacles.
Thank you. Dawah obstacles. Do you think there is obstacles?
You're amazing.
Right. Kindly mention in this paper 5, 2, 3 together, please. You have also 3 minutes on some obstacles of Dawah. There are so many obstacles. Mention what is the most important thing in your point of view.
Brother,
yes.
Dawah obstacle number one is...
Wait, don't attack us. Wait, you have 2 minutes. You have to work in a group.
Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So often we lose patience, and I think this is the greatest obstacle.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Yes, brothers. Yes, sir. Sisters, finish. Thank you.
May I say something, sir?
Yes. Sure.
Sir.
Sure. Kindly, you.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We
are a non-Muslim, a non-believer, can be.
Your name, please.
Muhammad Ali.
Thank you.
He can be indoctrinated by his own belief. It's not very easy to accept a new religion, it's a problem. And also ignorance, as my brother mentioned here, and the propaganda spread through the media, they can have a misconception about the religion. It's one of, I think, these are the, some of the obstacles I think I've come up with. Thank you.
Thank you.
Anyone else?
Next, yes. First line. Anyone else?
Assalamu alaikum. Maybe one of the society, Muhammad Ahmad.
Yes, Muhammad Ahmad.
One of the strategy of society and our any self presentation of Islam. We are not presenting a real or true picture of Islam. Also, we can say we don't try to spend the time for that. That's one of the stuff.
Thank you. It's a very, very important thing to sacrifice time. You know, now we are here. Who else sacrifices this time? People are enjoying their time now, here and there. You are here to sacrifice time for that. It's very important. Thank you. Thank you. You have something?
Assalamu alaikum. I can divide them to two main parts.
Your name?
Mohammed Ali.
Can you smile?
Okay.
Yes. Smile.
Okay. inner factors and outer ones.
Yes, thank you.
The inner factors can be divided into one, lack of knowledge,
thank you.
Sincerity, model and application. A generation that that is well brought up on the instructions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Outer factors like deformation of spiritual Islam in the West, for example.
Right.
We ourselves are not good models.
Right.
Sometimes lack of money, something like that.
You're right. Thank you. Next slide. Second row. You have the answer? Yes.
Assalamu alaikum. I'm Mir Rumi, working in Khalid University.
Yes.
Most of the points are discussed already,
yes.
But I have some new. Like I can say that no appropriate knowledge in the line of Islam.
Yes.
No goal is set. Then not using contemporary methods like internet,
yes.
Facebook, TV channels, and misconception of jihad.
Yes.
So that's all. We have more, but it will take time.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you. Yes. Next, anybody else? Here we go. I mean, next to you, I mean, brother Brahim.
Assalamu alaikum. Salaam. The biggest barrier is media propaganda.
Yes.
Okay, second one is terrorism acts, which reflect on the our society, in our community, which gives bad, you know, bad impression about Islam.
Yes.
Wrong interpretation, okay, and misunderstanding, misconception.
Yes.
Okay, I have certain lack of knowledge, lack of wisdom, lack of reading, lack of sincerity. Okay, all those, you know, combine.
Good. Yes.
Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillah. Being lazy by time and money about going down. Number two, other reactions the Muslims dealing with them. Number three, lack of Islamic appearance and knowledge. Number four, we don't understand other religions to speak to them from their point of view or culture.
Yes. Thank you. Very nice. Yes. Any other answer? The last one.
Hello, assalamu alaikum.
I
think language also is a barrier.
Yes.
And
you.
Politics.
Thank you. Great. Thank you, brothers and sisters. Now,
excuse me.
Yes.
I think one important point is missing. As a Muslims, our own behavior is also an obstacle.
Yes.
Because non-Muslims, they judge Islam by our behavior. So we project such behavior that they feel that they are like this because of Islam. So never accept Islam because Islam is this.
Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. Oh, let us go through the slides. Actually, they are endless obstacles. But let us go through some. And in addition to you have mentioned Jazakumullah Khair, you have mentioned so many useful things. Financial obstacles, which is said by Brother Muhammad. You cannot work without money. Political obstacles, as you said also. And human obstacles, human power. Will qualified da'i. Also is an obstacle. Strategies in which we are doing our best to solve or to help our partners like you through this course, which has been running for almost 6 weeks, 2 months almost, to know a lot of strategies will help you to convey the message. New clever invention. It was invented many years, and it is now anybody who has something to do it all over the world, he can do it by force, and he has the excuse. What do you think? Terrorism. You can attack any country and divide it, and because there is a terrorist in this country. Where is he? Nobody knows. Mass media empire, as you mentioned. Before it was the TV channels, and alhamdulillah now they are not so much important because they are controlled by some bad people, actually, either non-Muslims or Muslims. Some mass media is controlled and owned by some bad people, also Muslims. So now, alhamdulillah, instead of that, we have the social media. You can reach anybody, anywhere. Islamophobia. What they say now? They said, we had a conflict with the Soviet Union, and after that, the Soviet Union collapsed. Now, our real conflict is with whom now? With Muslims. And this is a historical disease because we are not enemies of anybody. We don't want actually to attack any country. We don't need wealth like them. We don't need power like them. Prophet Muhammad said at the beginning of his da'wah, let me reach people. خَلُّ بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَ النَّاسِ. If they do, he will not fight. If they let Prophet Muhammad to preach the message of Allah, it is not his own message, to people, he will not fight. And he didn't fight normal people. Only people who fight. Only people who prevent him of conveying the message. Even now, we as a Muslim, we don't want to occupy any country. We don't want to go anywhere. We like our places. We like our country. We have the holy places here. We don't want to go to Russia or the United States or to the East or West. We don't want to go anywhere. And alhamdulillah, we don't need to go. Social media now can do this. Without, they cannot prevent their people and their nation from hearing the truth. So, alhamdulillah, this this was many years before, but now with social media, alhamdulillah, we came off of this. Concentrating only on the West, people in the West. The universe has only West. Is there East? Is there South? What about Africa? What about Asia? Are they human beings? Do they need to live like what Allah wants them to live in Islam, in a right way, a right life? Yes, they do. Many years we are saying the West. Yes, they have the power. But now no need for power. With social media, we can reach the West and East. Spreading of innovations which distract Muslims and non-Muslims. Unfortunately, in the Muslim world, there is a big conflict, mainly in the West and the East Muslim countries. And one point will come later on, we'll explain this. Some Muslim communities Brother Muhammad has said we are not good examples of Islam. Weak or shy governmental support. We know how is the West supporting their charitable agencies and people when they preach Christianity or any other belief. Unfortunately, we don't. And also some governments are afraid about the chair, afraid about the power not to be lost. Majority of Muslim countries, mass media. As I told you, there is a series of media or channels, TV channels owned by Muslims, but they are spreading bad things among Muslims. Following or imitating person, not the idea. He's a Muslim in India, he's a Muslim in the USA, he's a Muslim in Saudi Arabia. But I am from Pakistan. If he is from my group, I follow him because of so on, because of X of people. And thousands of people are doing this. They are following the person, and they call them nation of so on and so on, group of so on and so on. Astray Islamic sects. And on the top of them is Shia. We will come to this, inshallah, later on. Self-confidence. Do we have self-confidence about our faith? All of us? All of Muslims? No. Some Muslims, they cannot perform Salah in the airport. When they travel abroad, they cannot perform their ibadah in a good way in any place. He has no self-confidence. Personal efforts, not constitutional work. Everyone works alone. He spends a lot of time, a lot of money, a lot of effort, but there is no result. While there are some offices or centers where he can actually practice and share his brother's da'wah. With communication between da'wah's organizations, sometimes in one city, there is no any cooperation between these some Islamic centers. Weak propagation for these organizations. Like in Abha Islamic Center, which hold this course, maybe some people in Abha, they don't know it. There is a weakness in propagation of these Islamic centers. As you said, weak qualification of some workers in these organizations. As I told you, endless obstacles. Lack of knowledge about Islam, distorted image of Islam by media and by bad examples of Muslims. Hesitation, being afraid, sometimes as we told, the missing word, don't forget it. Practice. He is shy or afraid or not to take the first step. Behaviors and manners. Before, Brother Hamad said the manners of some Muslims. Also behavior of some Muslims. Extremism. Backlash. And life example. Lack of knowledge about others. And it is very important for us. As Brother Ayyad said, you have to go back to the classification of people in your mind. Who is this person? Belongs to what belief? Or to which faith? Sharia's. Also, other police preachers who are spreading everywhere over the world. Sorry. Some Muslims governments. Am I right? Some Muslim governments prevent people from making doubt or preaching. There is a doubt, there is a gap between their nation, between them and their nation. Weak financial support, and now. By this we, alhamdulillah, we came over the main point about our lecture today, and time is running. As I told you, some stray sects, Muslim sects. And the first and the main one is Shia. They are active, but they are not active against non-Muslims. They are very active against Muslims. And not only all Muslims, only about them. And the West and East are very clever. They discover this early, and they work on this conflict between Sunni and Shia, even though they are minority, but they have money, they have international support, because they serve their policy. They accuse Muslims, they attack Muslims, they reflect a very bad image of Islam, either in their manner or in their behavior. I will run this from the computer because it will not run from the PowerPoint.
قناة نيزك لترجمة
In this video we will hear how people judge us through behavior of some Muslims. And this is these are recent examples, yesterday and the week before.
See someone in the back. Could you identify yourself, please?
Listen, please, to the question.
It's hard to see faces from here because of the lights.
I'm Christopher Bansach, Foreign Affairs Minister of the House of Commons in London. I'm a foreign minister. I hate to raise another elephant in the room. Both you and the Prime Minister of Iraq, indeed his dynasty, King Abdullah, before, all talked about Daesh being un-Islamic. Isn't, and I'm quoting here from an article in the Atlantic by a friend which you're almost certainly familiar with, the reality is that Islamic State is.
The reality. The reality is what?
Islamic. Very Islamic.
Very,
yes, it has a track.
Very Islamic State. This is the what are people think of Daesh in the West and East. And this is what is said in this forum.
And psychopaths and adventure seekers drawn largely from the disaffected populations of the Middle East and Europe, but the religion preached by those ardent followers derives from coherent and even learned interpretations of Islam. And the article goes on to advise us to base our strategy on countering Daesh with that understanding of Islam. So I invite you to comment on.
Every religion has perverts and psychopaths who try to hijack it. ISIS is as much Islamic as the KKK is Christian. Don't they have a cross? Don't they do everything in the name of religion and Christ? Don't they believe that Christ compels them to lynch and kill people of African descent?
They are not terrorists.
Can one really say that the KKK is a Christian organization?
It is not a Christian organization. It is, but nobody can say it.
There are other groups that one can point to. There are other massacres that were committed in the name of keeping certain countries or regions clear of non-Christians. There are people like this also in the Jewish faith that have nothing to do with Judaism. There are people like this in the Hindu faith that have nothing to do with Hinduism. For anyone to argue that Daesh is Islamic is preposterous. In the Islamic faith, the Quran reveals that you have your faith and I have my faith. And you're free to practice your faith and I'm free to practice mine. What greater sign of tolerance and acceptance do you have than this? In the Islamic faith it says, he who kills an innocent soul is as if he has killed all of humanity. And he who saves an innocent soul is as if he killed, as if he saved all of humanity. What more?
This is a verse in the Holy Quran.
What better example of compassion and mercy do you have than this? So if you look at what Daesh says and you say it's in the scriptures, doesn't the Old Testament say an eye for an eye and tooth for a tooth? If somebody does it today, would you say they were Christian or they were Jewish? So I caution people, because it seems to have become almost novel. Not novel, it's become the flavor of the day to try to read things into Daesh or into Islam that are not there. The Islamic religion and Islamic civilization was the civilization that preserved the history of Greek and Rome and passed it on to the West. Western civilization would not exist without the Islamic Arab civilization. The Islamic civilization and the Islamic Arab civilization was the civilization that connected China with Europe. So it was global. And the point I made early on about being an intermediate civilization, this is what I mean. So if Islam was intolerant and Daesh represented Islam, would Islam have preserved Aristotle and Socrates and passed it on to the West? Would Islam have connected Eastern civilization with Western civilization? Of course not. So I urge you, all of you, to be careful when it comes to making generalizations or to accepting generalizations that have no basis in fact. Thank you.
This is a sample of what they think of us.
Limit is not a religion.
The question was, what's your answer about the penalty death of scholar? The reporter said the Shia scholar, Nimr al-Nimr. And this was the answer.
Nimr is not a religious scholar, he's a terrorist. He's as much of a religious scholar as Osama bin Laden was. Nimr was a man who recruited, he justified, he funded, he equipped, he plotted, and he engaged in terrorist attacks that left a number of security personnel dead. He was caught in the middle of a raid, and so he was jailed. He was sent to court.
Well, last night or night before, the simple leader of Shia in the Arab Shia, I don't want actually to mention his name, but I have to, or you will listen to him. He said, our aim, our holy war, our holy effort is against Saudi Arabia, against Sunnah. He declared this many years, he couldn't, till after Yemen war, so he said what he had in his mind and his heart all the time.
في المقاومة وقدمنا أنصاري أنا وإخواني وقدمنا الشهداء والآخرين. إذا هلأ بتقول لي أشرف شيء عملته بحياتك، أفضل شيء عملته بحياتك، أعظم شيء عملته بحياتك، بقول لك هو الخطاب اللي ألقيته ثاني يوم من الحرب السعودية على اليمن.
He said, if you want to ask me what is the best thing I did in all my life, or I said, is my speech against Saudi Arabia when they start the war in Yemen. They call it a war in Yemen.
واللي عم نعمله. هيدا أعظم شيء بحياتي أنا.
This is the greatest thing in my life. This is, he says he's a Muslim.
وبشعر انه هيدا هو الجهاد الحقيقي.
I feel this is the real jihad. As I told you, their effort, their war, everything is faced toward Muslims, sons.
فتمص الله بنفسه القناع الذي ارتداه لعقود كاشفا عما يسميها حربه المقدسة. هذه الحرب هي ضد المملكة العربية السعودية.
His holy war is against Saudi Arabia. Why not against Egypt? Why not against Libya? Why not against India, Pakistan? Why not against Oman, Jordan? You know why? Because of the holy mosques here, they want to occupy Saudi Arabia, the Shia, Iran mainly, and to spread Shia belief, and not for this, the Iranian wants to control the area, throw this astray belief. This is from Hezbollah. He says he has an operation in Riyadh. We are planning for bombing in Riyadh. And he's from his group, from Lebanon, from Nasrullah group.
ممكن عمليه استشاريه، لانها عمليه استشاريه.
فضفاضة هي البراءة التي حاول نصر الله ان يوسم نفسه بها في بداية خطابه.
انا ما شطنت ولا بشكت. هاي كلي.
I didn't shout or say bad any, I didn't say any bad words towards anybody. Let us hear.
ولا بسر.
ما انتوا تنافق، انتوا كسالى، انتوا فاشلين، انتوا بتحملوا مسؤولياتكم.
He is in bad words accusing Saudi Arabia and other Muslim countries.
وبالحرب ضد السعودية كل الأسر بمشروعة بالنسبة لنصر الله.
خلي الموضوع الأخلاقي والمبدئي على جنب.
ومنها إلقاء التهم جزافا ومن دون دلائل.
أنا ذكرت عندي أرقام التليفونات. سيارات الفخخة الكنديشن بالقلمون على الهرمين وعلى النبي عثمان.
Saying some cars which from Syria to Lebanon to bomb there came from Saudi Arabia.
على الضاحية الجنوبية وعلى بيروت كانت تدار من السعودية.
هذا في حين أن الدلائل كلها تؤكد أن حليفه ميشيل سماحة هو من كان مسؤولا عن إدخال العبوات الناسفة من سوريا إلى لبنان. وجدد اتهام.
This is the person who planned the operation.
تهمه للمملكة بالعمل على الفتنة السنية الشيعية.
ما كان فينا نسكت عن الجرائم التي بدأتها السعودية في اليمن، ولذلك بلشنا نحكي عن مكشوف.
مكشوف.
This is now خلاص clear here, we talk clearly about his faith. You know, Taqiyya and Shia, they do something and in their mind and they have something else.
نصر الله حارب من حقيقة تمويل وتدريب ميليشياته للحوثيين في اليمن.
ونحن لسنا وحدنا بالمناسبة. هاي معركة كبرى موجودة اليوم بالمنطقة حتحدد مصير المنطقة من جملة لبنان.
رضوى الخطيب العربي.
So, dear brothers and sisters, say alhamdulillah. Now there are some websites that are actually very important and very helpful for a da'iyah to benefit from them. E-Dialogue belongs to Al-Hubar Islamic Center in the eastern province in Saudi Arabia. We will see it after a while. Islam Unveiled is our website, supervised by Dr. Abdullah Baishi, and we will see it later on. Islam House and Islam Tomorrow. This is our website. When you enter to this website, you can click here for free box. When you click free box, you will shift to this page. Click any book here. You can choose from 23 languages. In our website, there are 23 languages. You can only tick the book you choose and email it to our website. Brother Shakil and the group, the team in electronic da'wah, will email the requested books anywhere all over the world. You can advise to anybody who wants to mail it. Islam House. And it has the name, the real name, Islam House. There are 114 languages. And they have 5,071 books. And a lot of materials, pamphlets, brochures, etc. E-Dialogue, the first one I talked about it, this is their main website. This is a live online website. That is, anybody who is who wants, and they have really they have a very nice words and a very nice website, you can guide anybody to this. And by the way, 1 week, at least 100 new Muslims all over the world. When you click to the start chatting, it is online website, you get into this, you write the name and email and start chatting. When you start chatting, a volunteer da'iya all over the world, from maybe 15 countries all over the world, are conveying, explaining, preaching Islam to the whole world. And we will conclude with this Abha Islamic Center. We have actually field work, and this is what is needed here and there and everywhere. We have some examples, we will conclude with them. We have Hajj and Umrah programs for all brothers who attend our programs. Offer than 400 attend our program every Friday. New Muslim caring and following up. We have Brother Yusuf Benjamin, where is he? And three other da'iya, in addition to seven well-qualified da'iya graduated from Islamic University working with us, taking care of the new Muslims. They help him, they visit him in his house, his company, his place, even here in Abha Private Hospital they came, and they help him to practice ibadah. Da'wah exhibition, we have it everywhere here in Abha. We have the main book exhibition and one on the road built in the university, airport exhibition, everywhere we do it. Open day for each nationality, one group, Bengali, Filipino, Indonesian, they have open day. Last one was for our brothers from Philippines. The first day, seven brothers embraced Islam in the same day. Community kids taking care, teaching them Arabic, teaching them English, teaching them Holy Quran, reciting and memorization. Jum'ah educational program, as I told you, more than 400 attend in our Islamic center. All activities that I mentioned now, we have a similar activity for our sister to do it with the lady section in celebration yearly. Teaching Arabic, maybe some brothers here attend this course. It is Many brothers who attend this course embrace Islam. They were non-Muslims and they embrace Islam. They saw the beauty of Islam through this course. Da'wah tours, they go everywhere, companies, hospitals, workshops, houses, everywhere. As I told you, we have seven da'ya. Tarafilar bag, this bag was designed by some brother, a volunteer, and he paid the money and everything. In this bag, sometimes brother come or a visitor come to Saudi Arabia and he stays sometimes 10 years, 1 year, 1 month, more, less, and he doesn't know anything about Islam. He's non-Muslim, and sometimes when he's a Muslim, he comes with the mistakes, with the innovations, and he go back with them. So this bag is designed, and it is free for anybody to get it and distribute it. Holy Quran teaching, it's very important activity for us. Jum'ah speech in English. We have this khutbah in English in our center every Jum'ah. A new repairs house, you know, alhamdulillah, now we have offer them 5,500 and so on new Muslims. So they are searching to for a place to stay or to spend their time weekend to learn Islam and ibadah and behavior. Ramadan breakfast lessons, we benefit from these tents, this big gathering of Muslims and sometimes non-Muslims on the meals during breakfast to give some lessons. Da'iyah qualification and developing. We have, as I told you, seven da'iyah graduating from the Islamic University in Medina, but not yet finished the story. They joined many courses to develop themselves and their abilities of da'wah. Da'wah sport tournament, which is held every year. Now for our, you know, there is no Filipinos here. It is held now in the court near Asir Central Hospital. Alhamdulillah, weekly we have new Muslims. Now almost 28 or 27 new Muslims embrace Islam during this tournament. Da'wah picnics. Each community go with the da'iyah to the beach, to anywhere, to spend one day, make da'wah to them, and have meal, and enjoy themselves. I think here the fish, here mashallah, the Indonesian. Distinguished student caring. We have some students attend our lectures or our programs, and they are elite. Distinguished, clever, intelligent, we take care of them in a special courses. Patient visiting and making da'wah in the hospitals or houses. Aqeedah ambassadors, alhamdulillah, we have 50 Aqeedah ambassadors. Each da'iyah has at least 10 from the community are well prepared to make da'wah and practice da'wah when they go back to their home back. Approaches and manners, this course which you are in now. Winter and Eid clothing distributed free for poor people. New Muslim gift. Each brother or sister who embraces Islam with his own gift. That's all. Thank you very much for attending, for sacrificing this time to participate us, to be our partner making da'wah. I hope we conclude our lecture, inshallah, with something in mind, that the missing word and the huge question. The huge question is how to compare Islam or preach Islam, or what is Islam? This is the huge question, which has a simple answer given to us by Jibreel. And we have the missing word in da'wah in addition to knowledge, which is practice. Applying as my brother said. Thank you very much. SubhanAllah wa bihamdih. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.